Hello guys, today we are going to learn about types of weathering. Weathering is a process that involves the breaking down of rocks into smaller particles, and the process occurs on the surface of the earth. There are three types of weathering: physical or mechanical, chemical and biological or organic weathering. In this slide, you can see the pictures of physical, chemical, biological weathering. Now we are going to know about physical weathering. Physical weathering are also known as mechanical weathering. Physical weathering makes rocks crumble. Physical weathering occurs when physical forces break rocks into smaller and smaller pieces without change the rock mineral's composition. Pressure, warm temperature, water, wind, waves, gravity and ice are common causes of physical weathering. The process of rocks breaking apart without changing their chemical composition. Physical weathering effect of rain. Rainwater collects in a crack and the temperature falls below 0 degrees, the water freezes and expands, making the crack bigger. After repeating freezing and thawing, the rocks breaks off. Physical weathering caused by water. Physical weathering caused by water. Rocks often experience physical weathering as a result of exposure to swiftly moving water. Water flowing in a stream into a rock can eventually create a hole in the rock. When the water in a river or stream moves quickly, it can lift up rocks from the bottom of that body of water. When the rocks drop back down, they bump into other rocks and tiny pieces of rocks can break apart. Many rocks' surfaces have small creeks on them. Water can freeze in these creeks when it is cold and then melt when the weather is warmer. This repeated freezing and thawing creates ice wedges which can cause rocks to break. The rushing of powerful waves towards cracks found within rocks can trap a layer of air at the bottom of the crack. When a wave retreats, the air that was trapped can be released with a powerful force, thus weakening the rock. Physical weathering due to pressure. Glacier movement can cause pressure release as it moves away from the surface of a rock. Ice wedges are a big cause of potholes in roads and streets. As ice forms in the crack of a street, the water expands and pushes against the surrounding rock, making the cracks wider, eventually breaking apart the rock. Physical weathering. The other factors that can cause physical weathering in nature. Forest and rainforests can cause rocks that are located along the surface of the ground in the affected area to undergo weathering. As a result, rocks in areas impacted by forest fires often appear quite different from those in other areas. Physical weathering. Physical weathering caused by salt crystallization is common along coastlines. When saline solution gets inside of the zones or cracks in rocks, the solution can later evaporate and leave behind salt crystals. As the crystals heat up, they expand, they put pressure on the rock. Sodium sulfate, calcium chloride, and magnesium sulfate are salts that are quite good at disintegrating rocks. Physical weathering related to temperature. Exposure to extreme temperature fluctuation can cause rocks to weather. Rocks expand and contract as they go through heat cycles of hot and cold temperatures, which led to the formation of cracks. Chemical weathering. When a chemical reaction is the cause, it's called chemical weathering. In chemical weathering, rocks and minerals are reacting to acids, oxygen, carbon, and water. That's why no two rocks ever look exactly the same. It's also the reason that we have those awesome-looking caves. and unique rocks formation all over the world. An example of chemical weathering is when the acid in rainwater removes calcium from limestone. The most common types of chemical reactions that induce chemical weathering are carbonation, oxidation, hydration, hydrolysis, and acidification. Carbonation. As rain goes through the air and into the ground, it grabs carbon dioxide, creating carbonic acid. This weak acid reacts with the calcium carbonate in stones when it seeps into the cracks. A stone that is particularly susceptible to carbonation is limestone, which is made of mostly calcium carbonate. In the picture, you can see the carbonation of limestone creates unique structures like South China crust. Karsts are all over the globe and include unique caves, streams, sinkholes, and usual rock formation. In the picture, you can see the limestone that has undergone chemical weathering. In this picture, you can see the Great Sphinx of Egypt. Now we are going to learn about biological weathering. Biological or organic weathering. Organic weathering refers to the breaking down of rocks caused by living organisms such as through the release of acidic compound by plants and animals. Weathering which take place when plants' roots grow into rock and crack or break the rock into smaller pieces. A good example for biological weathering is algae, lichens, bacteria, and mosses often grow on rock surfaces, especially in humid regions. They produce weak acids which convert some of the minerals to clay. The algae growth can weaken many rock types and make it more open to weathering. Weeds and plants' roots can get into cracks of rocks and grow from there. As the plant grows bigger, the roots grow bigger and deeper, widening cracks and splitting them apart. Decaying roots also add organic acids to the joint, speeding up the weathering process.